morning everyone. My name is Mansi Sanjay Kumar Suryavanshi. My today's topic name is respiratory system. It is a series of organs responsible for taking in oxygen and expelling out carbon dioxide. The primary organ in this are lungs which carry out these changes of gas as we breathe. There are two types of respiratory system. First of all, upper respiratory tract, and second, lower respiratory tract. The function of respiratory system is first gas exchange, the vital life sustaining process where we inhale oxygen and exhale carbon dioxide. Second, helping maintaining of the homeostasis in that blood pH balances and O2 absorbed with the cell. It helps to maintain the acid-base balance in our body. Third, speech production. First being sound production through a vocal field fold around the larynx and the forming sound with the vocal folds, mouth, nose, tongue and jaw. The parts of respiratory system in that upper respiratory tract and lower respiratory tract. In upper respiratory tract, it consists of nose, pharynx, larynx, and the organ of the upper respiratory tract are located in outside the chest and in nasal cavity. Inside the nose, the sticky mucous membrane and hair lining, the nasal cavity membrane traps the most of the dust particle and the sinus. In that, it helps to regulate temperature and humidity of air we breathe by warming and moisturizing it. And it is the air-filled spaces alongside the nose helps to make a skull lighter. And in pharynx, food and air pass through the pharynx before reaching the appropriate destination and also plays an important role in the speech. In larynx, it is essential to the human speech and it also known as voice box. Then the lower respiratory tract. It consists of trachea, lungs and all the segments of bronchial trees included of alveoli. The organ of the lower respiratory tract are located inside the chest cavity. In trachea, located just below the larynx, and it is the main airway of the lower respiratory tract. And this is also known as windpipe, and it has a tiny hair called cilia and leaning and a trap that it bronchiates into the bronchi, and there are two tubes that are carry air into the each lungs. And then next part is bronchi. To supply air in a lungs, it include a line with the tiny hairs called cilia, and its cilia move back and forth carrying mucus up and out, and the mucus are sticky fluid collected, and dust, germs are inhaled in lungs, has inhaled in lungs, and it leads to lobe of the lung. Then lungs, they are the pyramid shape and paired organ system that are connected to trachea with the right and left bronchi. And there are in right lungs there are three lobes are present, and in left lungs there are two lobes are present, and lobes filled with the small and sponge called alveoli, and the left lung is smaller to allow room for the heart. Then diaphragm, the main type is relaxation and contraction. Then respiratory epithelium, it also known as pseudostratified columnar epithelium, and the bronchioles are lined by simple cuboidal. In osmosis, there are lower to high concentration, and in diffusion, higher to lower concentration occur. The gas exchange mechanism, in that alveoli in the lungs have filled with the air, and the process called as the gaseous exchange, and the oxygen move from air in the alveoli into the blood capillaries, and while carbon dioxide moves from the blood in the capillaries into the air in alveoli. The illness in respiratory system, in that upper respiratory tract illness and lower respiratory tract illness, in that common cold, sinusitis, sore throat are in upper respiratory tract, and pneumonia, asthma, and tuberculosis is it included.